Good Wednesday morning. This is the Great Basin Smoke Dispersion Briefing for Wednesday, October 31st. Looking at precipitation, it's been quite dry across the southern two-thirds of the Great Basin for the past 2 weeks. Only significant amounts of precipitation you can see here on the left and on the right. Across western Wyoming, the highest terrain of central Idaho, and about 2 weeks ago, across some areas of southern Utah. However, in the past 7 days, if you look to the left, just about all areas have dried out considerably, especially across the western Great Basin. In terms of snow and the snowfall, we do expect to see some light to locally moderate amounts coming up, but in the past 72 hours, we've had several inches of snow here on the left-hand side across the mountains of central Idaho into the western Wyoming. Some of the highest amounts here in these yellow shades of 6 to 8 inches, lesser amounts in the shades of blue looking by the key on the lower left-hand side. In terms of existing snow cover, we're getting towards that time of year, traced to 2 inches, maybe some locally higher pockets across the higher terrain of Idaho, and some of the highest terrain in western Wyoming has anywhere from 8 to 12 inches of snow, as does the higher terrain, and especially the northern slopes of the Uintas and some of the highest terrain of the mountains of central Utah. Now we've dried out quite a bit, and we look at the 100-hour fuel moisture, and they're quite dry across the western Great Basin, 6 to 10%. So with those drier fuels, pretty decent burning conditions across Nevada and into most of Utah as well, and southern Idaho, more moist conditions as you head further north. Now looking at our satellite imagery, we have we're under the influence of a trough of low pressure, one trough exiting Utah at the moment. Another storm system, though, pushing into the Pacific Northwest, approaching, will bring clouds and showers into Idaho and Utah and Wyoming later tonight into tomorrow, with snow levels lowering quite a bit, down to maybe 5 to 6,000 feet in a lot of areas. So looking at the weather map for later this afternoon, you see the cloud cover moving into the northern portion of the Great Basin. Showers arrive, more widespread showers the further east you go. Dispersion overall limited because of the cloud cover, so areas in the purple shades have the lowest overall dispersion. Yellow to white shades have the best overall dispersion. We can spot that out both horizontally with transport winds on the left and vertically with mixing heights on the right. On the mixing height side, the greener shades indicate better overall dispersion, bluer shades indicate lower overall dispersion. Now we get into Thursday, November 1st, still under the influence of moisture and cool air coming out of this northwest flow. High pressure building into California and into western Nevada with warming and drying and northerly flow. Dispersion overall fairly poor due to some surface cold air trapped in. You can see again transport winds on the left, mixing heights on the right. As we go into Friday, November 2nd, still some waves of disturbances pushing through Idaho and parts of Wyoming, maybe far northern Utah. Dispersion in the purple remains fairly poor overall. Transport winds on the left, pretty windy across parts of Idaho and Wyoming, mixing heights on the right hand side. Now we look at the Utah Clearing Index as we go from Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, and you can see where good conditions exist in the red shades, poor overall dispersion in the blue and purple shades. Precipitation totals over the next 3 days, you can see them mostly across the higher terrain of Wyoming, the higher terrain of Idaho, and portions of northern Utah, mostly in the light side, perhaps a tenth to a quarter of an inch, and much of this above 6,000 feet is going to be in the form of snow, so possibly 1 to 3 inches, but locally higher amounts of up to 10 inches across the higher terrain of the Tetons. Now on Saturday, still seeing moisture coming out of the Pacific Northwest, so starting increased cloud cover into parts of northwestern Idaho. Dispersion improves, lots of areas in the white here. Now the storm system plows through on Sunday into parts of northern Nevada and Utah, clears out of Idaho and Wyoming, good overall dispersion. Monday, still in that northwest flow, on the right-hand side, still overall good dispersion. Tuesday, we start to see some drier air punching in, these tannish and copper shades through here. Dispersion starts to take a hit as we go into the middle of next week. Now, precipitation accumulation, this will be from from Saturday night through Monday night, you see additional amounts in these blue shades here of 3/4 of an inch or an inch, eastern Idaho into western Wyoming. Most of that will be in the form of snow, so another 8 to 10 inches of snow up there, maybe more. Still some light to moderate amounts across Utah and Idaho, but bone dry across most of Nevada and the southern half of Utah and the Arizona Strip. Now the 8 to 14 day outlook shows an above normal temperature signal for southern and western portions of the Great Basin, a drier than normal signal for most areas as well, especially the further west you go. This concludes our briefing. Have a great day. Our next smoke briefing will be this coming Friday.